This week on The Wire, cut price lenders counter APRA moves, house prices to surge, says Westpac, and peak of tenure crunch has passed. G'day guys, my name is Tim Guest and welcome to The Wire, the week in real estate. We can get all the top stories happening this week in real estate, finance, investment and more. Kicking it off with our top story for this week, cut price lenders counter APRA moves. So lenders are continuing to offer cut price interest rates and financial incentives to home buyers despite moves by the financial regulator to rein in borrowing. Now the Commonwealth Bank and ING both cut their variable interest rates last week for new customers with larger deposits, and according to comparison website RateCity, 28 lenders have cut at least one of their variable rates in the past month. Now analysts are predicting the continued competition from banks will reduce the impact of the APRA move to require banks to more cautiously assess home loan customers. Now, banks must assess new borrowers at an interest rate 3 percentage points higher than the actual rate of their loan, when it was previously 2.5 percentage points. Now, Macquarie analyst Victor German says APRA may need to introduce further measures to counter the bank's continued reductions in interest rates. And now, guys, moving on to our next story. House prices to surge, says Westpac. So the continued strength of the property market has bank economists predicting home prices will increase 22% by the end of the year. Now, Westpac economists had initially forecast an 18% increase, but current market conditions have prompted them to revise that figure to 22%. Now, property prices across the major capital cities have increased on average by 17% in the 12 months to September and are on track to increase another 1.5% in October. Now, Westpac predicts the end of the Melbourne and Sydney lockdowns will lead to further upward pressure on prices. Now, Chief Economist Bill Evans says reopening will offset any dampening of prices caused by APRA moves to rein in lending. He tips price growth to continue into 2022, although the pace of growth may slow. Now, Westpac is predicting an interest rate rise in early 2023, despite the Reserve Bank confirming that it does not expect to increase rates until 2024. And moving on, guys, to our final story of the week. Peak of timber crunch has passed. So the timber shortage caused by the massive increase in housing construction appears to finally be easing. Housing Industry Association economist Angela Lillycrap says a drop in overseas timber prices, better planning from builders and new support from the federal government means projects will now speed up and eventually domestic timber prices will drop. She says it's not going to get any worse. We've seen that timber prices in the US and Canada come off quite rapidly, so it's only a matter of time before that extra timber supply comes to Australia. Now, about 80% of the timber used in Australian housing construction is still sourced locally, but the massive increase in demand as a result of home builder has meant many looked overseas for supplies. Now, according to the Master Builders Association, timber-related delays to construction times at the moment are up to 3 months. Lillycrap says some builders had to resort to using steel frames instead of timber during the shortages. Well, guys, they are the top stories happening this week. Now, please don't forget to like, comment and share this video and follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. Have a great week. And remember, guys, there's only one thing in life that makes a difference. That's action. Thanks a lot. Bye for now.